Hello, Missouri Mama here. My name is Gina, and today I am doing a catch-up video. The first Tuesday of February, I was supposed to do a date night look with the other girls in the Unicorn Glam Squad. But we were remodeling my front room, which includes my area, and I was not able to get it done, so I'm going to do it now. I already have a base on. It doesn't even look like I'm wearing makeup. It looks like I'm wearing some moisturizer, which is really awesome. It doesn't feel like makeup. So I was trying out some new stuff. Not all of it was new, but stuff I'd gotten from Amazon Vine. Just trying it out, see what I thought. And so far, I actually really like it. I have some blush and contour on. I didn't highlight because the blush already has it's a shimmery blush. It's a liquid blush. And it's already giving me that highlight effect, so I didn't need any. So, for me, for date night, my hubby is not into a lot of makeup. So I would go more on a more natural, just to kind of tour. I still have my makeup, but it's kind of like in between the two of our preferences, you know, because I like a lot of color and he likes no makeup. Like he never complains when I wear makeup, except for he doesn't like the feeling of lipstick or lip gloss, so I can't kiss him if I'm wearing a lot of lip products. But doesn't stop me from wearing them anyways. So I'm going for a more natural look. Something I'd do more for, you know, just a night out. We're not huge on to like doing big, huge things, going fancy places. We're more of like a casual, can wear jeans and a t-shirt to the place type people. So I straightened my hair. For a date night, it would either be straightened or be all scrunched up. And I wanted to try out a straightener that I got from Amazon Vine, so I straightened it. And the straightener worked amazing. I actually was really impressed with that. But let's jump into the makeup look. So I am going to start with this look. These stick that I actually got from Amazon Prime. Most of the stuff is going to be from Amazon Prime just because I want to try it out. And a more natural look is kind of the best time for me to do that. So this is just like a cream pencil. It's got a brush on the end. So I'm just going to use this kind of as like a base, a primer. Just put on a little thin layer. Sorry about the noise. I'm not meaning to make so much noise with that. And I'm going to go ahead and test the brush. You know, the brushes usually suck. This one's like super soft. I'm just kind of see if I can blend some of that out. Oh, the brush actually does good for blending it out. Let me see if I can build up the color a little bit. I can see it, but I don't know if you really can. So I just want to see if I can make it a little bit darker. And mostly like the crease and upper area. I'm not really worried about the lid so much. I'm putting other stuff there. this is supposed to be a light color, obviously. More natural color. I'm going to take this liquid from Luxeza, the same brand as the pencil. A little bit over here in the corner. I'm going to blend that out in a second. I just want it to dry a tad bit. Jesus, why do I keep doing that? I'm gonna take this pencil blender. Well, that is. I was trying to darken up the corner. Hopefully I didn't muddy it up. So I'm going to take a little bit of this and put it on my hand. Just so I can get a finer line with this brush. But now I just have to put on a thicker coat. Right along the eyelash line. Almost like it's a wing liner. can I use the brow brush? I'm going to use these for brows. Or is it going for making my lines? That's just how I use them. And I have this shade. I don't really see what the name is anywhere. Neither does this one. But they are different. Not by a lot. They are a little bit different. I'm going to do this one the same way because I don't want to put on too much. I'm going to try to keep looking down until that dries up a bit. So I went over with this Shadow Stick by Camuse in shade 2. It's a really pretty like brown goldy shade. Like a champagne color. It's really pretty. I just went over that one to lighten it up a little bit. And so get it underneath the lash line. Just add some color there. I'll wipe off my hand. I'm gonna take the eyeshadow stick by Camuse. This one's in shade 1. It's a pinky color. I'm gonna use that in the inner corner. Like a satiny shade, but I thought it would work good for this look. We'll see. That may not be the best choice here. I had to use a smudge shader. I'm just gonna see if I can blend that out a little bit. And I think I want to use something else to get a little bit more pop to the inner corner. Out of that line of the brownie color to kind of blend the crease a little bit more. Just a second. So you'll see this in a haul, an Amazon Vine haul. It's the Beauty Baton by Ready Set Jet. It's got contour, which I used today, and it's got a highlighter, which I didn't need to use on my cheeks because the blush had shimmer in it already. But I think this would be really pretty on the inner corner. And it's not too bright. With that, I will be right back from drawing mascara and stuff. So this is my finished look. I think it looks pretty. Looks natural. Another reason why I would have went with more natural makeup is because I have anxiety issues. So if we go out somewhere in public, the more comfortable I can feel, the better because of my anxiety. So wearing lighter makeup, makeup that doesn't feel heavy or feel like I'm wearing makeup, would be more comfortable. The lips are bright, but that's because I'm using a lip oil that does the whole color change thing. And the reason why I chose this is because it stains. So whenever it wears off, there should be some pink tint, and I can always reapply it if I want to easily. This would fit in my bag, my purse, without any problems if I carry my tiny purse. So, and it smells amazing. It smells like green apples. So, yeah. I really like how the look turned out. Let me know what you think down below. I need to clean up right here and I forgot. Whoops. Yeah, but let me know down below. Maybe I give you some ideas of ways to use liquid eyeshadow, hopefully. Using it as a liner works really good. It looks pretty that way, I think, in my opinion. Using it with a brush is really easy. It's a good way to get it just kind of be more thinner, finer lines. And you don't have to put it on your hand if you're uncomfortable with that. You can get like the little makeup palettes. You could put it on your mirror if you wanted to. You know, you try to clean it up, but that's normal. So, and it's also good when you use your brush. You can also like, it's already dried on this one. What's that other one that I was using? Here we go. Yeah, see? So, like, there's still some on there, but... So, you can take it and put it on, and then you can kind of... You see that? You can blend it out with a brush. Really nice. So, and I mean, you could go thinner, like, blending it out. And now I'm picking all of it back up because I dried the brush out. But if you use a brush with your liquid eyeshadows, you can do a lot of things and make it look really awesome. So let me know what you think down below of my look. If you're interested in anything, you can let me know. I can link it. It's not an affiliate link or anything. It'd just be the link to find it on Amazon if you saw anything you like. The only thing that I didn't get from Amazon is the black eyeliner. The mascara I used is from Amazon. The lip oil. All the eyeshadow products. My blush. Probably couldn't even tell that I contoured at all, but... That like gold, that like shimmer you see on my cheeks, that's the blush that did that. It's absolutely gorgeous. I love it. So, in the foundation, it doesn't feel like I'm wearing any foundation, but it is covering stuff. I didn't use any primer because I wanted to see how the foundation works, so you can see like my pores and stuff. But next time I try it, I will try it with a primer and see how it goes. I just wanted to kind of see how it worked because it's a 4-in-1. And I wasn't sure what that was all about, but I actually really like it. Next time I want to do a little bit more bronzing, like add some bronzer. I just didn't today. I didn't really want to feel like I was wearing a lot of makeup for this look. I even used powder over it, and I still don't feel like I'm wearing foundation. Like, I feel like I'm wearing mascara and stuff on my lips, but I don't feel like I'm wearing, like, foundation or blush or any of that. It's actually really nice. So, let me know what you think down below. If you like videos like this, please hit like and subscribe. It really helps me out, and I hope you all have a wonderful day. Thank you. Bye.